Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
Today, Wal Thornhill concludes his initial reports on the New Horizons mission to the dwarf planet Pluto. A fundamental question is, must scientists now reconsider the idea that Pluto and its moons are primordial bodies?
More complexity and assumptions will be needed to force-fit Pluto and the moons of the giant planets into the straitjacket of the Nebular hypothesis. More money and resources will be wasted on a futile quest. Sadly, the drawing boards have all been inscribed with permanent markers. Finally, Alan Stern referred to predictions he and a co-author had made in the Astrophysical Journal in May, and I quote, "The steep topography means that the bedrock that makes those mountains must be made of water ice. So even before the composition team tells us that they found places where the nitrogen veneer has been eroded or scraped off, and we see water ice on Pluto for the first time, we can be very sure that the water is there in great abundance." And actually, models predicted that, but it's nice to see it driven home. Well, the other thing that that means is that the volatiles are just a frosting, just a veneer on the surface. Now, the sticking point in this is that Pluto's atmosphere is being lost to space at a rate of a few times 10 to the 27th tons per second. And over the age of the solar system, that corresponds to the loss of an equivalent layer of between 300 meters of nitrogen and 3 kilometers of nitrogen. So if we only see a veneer, which we now know, what's going on? The predictions made in the paper suggested that steep topography and a thin veneer of volatiles on Pluto would require internal activity to dredge up nitrogen through cryovolcanism or geysers or some other process acting into the present on Pluto. No evidence has been found of cryovolcanism or volcanoes, but it will be the subject of an intensive search. Pluto's atmosphere loss is simply a result of its recent orphaning. There is no need to make up an unlikely cover story that has us seeing Pluto just as it loses the last of a kilometre's thick ice cover. Similarly, seeing traces of water ice on Pluto's surface cannot guarantee it is there in abundance. It is only required by the failed nebula hypothesis. We have seen the same claim of iciness for every visit to a comet, but the story is so ingrained that dry and rocky comets have not silenced such claims. The same is about to happen at comet 67P. There are no primordial bodies in or about the solar system. The Sun was formed in isolation and adopted its family at intervals afterwards. The geological record of global catastrophe and the fossil record of great dyings mark changes in the solar system at such times of chaos. Astronomers mislead geologists with their uneventful evolutionary story of the solar system. And to complete the deadly embrace, geologists mislead astronomers with their stories, which assume the Earth being a closed system for most of its mythical 4.5 billion years history. So we see again and again the old story of the solar system and its slow evolution treated as fact, which then requires all kinds of ad hocery to save appearances. In contrast, the electric universe embraces the totality of human experience and paints an entirely new picture of our place in the universe that is real, coherent, simple, and predictive. Pluto is not a surprise. What's more important in a world that seems increasingly meaningless, the electric universe inspires people to participate and think for themselves.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.